the idea of music being an expression of your soul, the idea is music being a means to communicate both to God and to man, is very, very serious for me.
I've been labeled very much a traditionalist and have felt very often guilt feelings because I should be like my colleagues and, you know, pushing along and writing avant-garde music. But because perhaps of my late start, or perhaps because of the cantorial influence, perhaps because of a personal need, I've just got to go along in this particular way until I find the right path, and then if it goes that way, okay. If not, I'll write this way the rest of my life.
I think he wrote this way all the rest of his life, but he incorporated some of that way as he went along.
I think there was a contest. He was fighting to find his voice, but on the other hand, he was fighting to stay safe at home. I think he had a little bit of a fear of stepping out and how he might be received. And you know, there's nothing worse that an artist can live with than a fear of failure. And I think he may have had a touch of that. Maybe.
In the 1960s, Glick began a lifelong juggling act. He had a full-time job as a music producer with the CBC. He was music director of Bet Tikva Synagogue. He was teaching young composers, and he was still trying to leave enough time for his own work and for his young family. So how did he keep it all together?
He was an extremely disciplined person. Why? Because he was desperate to be a composer. He wanted to be a good father, he wanted to be a good provider, but he desperately wanted to be a musician and a composer, and in order to do that he had to be very disciplined, so he structured his life. And that was quite amazing.
Because he was a producer at CBC, he would get off awfully early. He had a soundproof room that wasn't quite soundproof. My name is Stefan Glick, I'm Srul's son. We would hear him very early in the morning sketching, playing things over and over again, fitting them together.
I'm Paula Glick, and I'm Srul's youngest daughter. Actually, he was the one that woke us up in the morning, but he was already up, and had already been in his room composing, which was right next to my parents' bedroom, and that was his time. It was very clear that it was a time for him to be left alone. So we didn't really disturb him. And when he opened the door and came out and would make breakfast or whatever, that was it. And then he was off to work.
He was a very motivic composer. He needed, whether it be the building blocks of melody, the rhythmic blocks, he sensed he could be very creative and go off in different directions as long as there was a tremendous coherence to his work. We would often look at what constructed his melodies, the motivic qualities. It could be a three-note figure, it could be a six-note figure, but always trying to reduce it to the basic blocks of his composition, and that they shouldn't be forgotten. And that if a new theme was developed, or a new aspect was the second movement, or a middle movement didn't have coherence with the first one, he would put it aside.